playing with the memes, you don't wanna see me, dawg. My Jamaican nigga smoke you like a beaded dawg. Focused on that paper, all them haters, I don't see it all. Watch your fucking mouth, my kind of problems, you don't need it all. Stood tall against the Reaper and the Fed case. Hollin' out, I ain't got shit to say in the Fed face.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Edward here, back with another video. So today's analysis basically is the end of the week analysis. It was a weird week. It was some nice setups. Like today, I was not able to trade. I was not doing that much today. I was doing some things on like personal stuff. But I was not able to trade that much. So it was kind of interesting because last night, the market dropped. US 30 and S&P 500, they kind of did a little drop, and but Nasdaq actually was pushing, so it was kind of weird. Like the direction for Nasdaq was up, and look at US 30 actually was dropping, was actually coming back down, and it stopped me out. I did an entry actually here last night, and during the night it looks like there was some news in Europe and affected the market, because, and it only affected US 30. It did affect it, I'm lying. It did affect it, Nasdaq, but just a little bit. But at the end of the day, actually started to push up and continue pushed up. So new record highs. I'm going to start from a fresh chart right here. I always recommend you this, okay? By the end of the week, just close everything or remove everything and then start again from a scratch, okay? We see from here, you know, previous highs, previous records, previous highs being broken, did a pullback and continuation to the upside. But do you think, guys, that this is the actual pullback, like from this push? Do you think this is the actual pullback or not? What do you guys think? Let me see. Even right there on a 4 hour, you're starting to see a divergence now, okay? I will tell you this, divergence on RSI, it's a good sign that the market or the trend will be ending, okay? Now, don't get me wrong, not just because you're seeing a divergence here, it all the time means that, no. Sometimes it will just continue and we'll do the pullback later. Now, it may not complete a pullback. It may just not do the pullback, the one that we are expecting. Like, for example, look at right here, this entire push, how long was that push? Pretty much how long it took, pretty much until it started actually falling to all the way to here. So 110 days up, basically. It did just a few little corrections like it did here, like it's doing right here, right? So it might still not come back down, okay? It is expensive, yes. The market right now, the stock market in overall, it's very expensive. At least for NASDAQ, you know, the stocks on NASDAQ, they are looking very expensive right now. And how do you know that also? Like, I always recommend you using the 50, at least the 50 simple moving average. If you go on the daily, right, and you choose your, you pick your 50 simple moving average, and you will see that normally the market will separate. I know I mentioned this several times, but I want you guys to understand. You see when the market separates, goes very far away from the 50 SMA, it will normally try to come back to retest the zone, okay? Normally, all right? Right now, we are very far away, very, very far away. And it's expected, you know? A drop or a correction is definitely expected. So right now, I'm going to draw that zone on the daily, okay? We are still close to this zone, so this is an important zone right there, right? On the daily now, you can call this is another daily zone, or if you want to do, I don't know, 4 hours or daily, you know, as long as you're doing this on a bigger time frame, that's fine. Let's see how it looks on a 4 hour. Yeah, it's gonna give you an idea, right? So this is a daily zone. This is a nice zone right here. Okay, it could be a 4 hour zone as well. It's just the market just stopped right there. I put it on the body. Right here, you can do the same. You can just maybe put it there on the top of these four lines or right here, whatever. You can do it maybe at that last high, okay? Perhaps here there's another zone. Yes, there's always multiple zones right there, right? Well, let's pay attention now to that previous record high, okay, like we're doing here. The price broke that and continue pushing up. So right now you see the market breaking that very strong to the upside. And now this is our next level, right? Our previous level right there. So what could happen next week? The market could, you know, after this nice push, slowly, but, you know, pushing up, definitely, the market could do a pullback. And then perhaps, if it wants to continue pushing up, it perhaps it could continue pushing up that way, okay? So pullback is expected. I am waiting for that pullback, okay? Right now, I'm not looking for a buy right there because you are already, you know, very high on top. So it's very high. The market is very expensive. So, you know, if you're on an uptrend, you gotta wait for the pullback and enter on the pullback. If you still want to go buying, you wait for the pullback, find your trigger, find your zone, and then you find your entry, you know, where you can actually make your entry right there. So that's how it's looking right now. NASDAQ, a pullback is expected for next week. Let's see the RSI. Hi, yeah, you see there is a little divergence in there. You can, this is a nice trend right there. Let me hide this. From here. Yeah, it's a trend. It may not be a perfect trend, but you got it there. Let me hide the 50. All right. You see multiple touches on that trend. So, yeah, price could come closer. It may not reach this zone, but it could come closer to this so you can actually find a buy somewhere around this zone, okay, on the pullback. So what you can do, you can use your Fibonacci, okay, from the low of this push to the high right there. So you see the market could actually come back down, get to the golden zone, and right here, if you spot an actual trigger, you know, bullish engulfing, you know, something that will tell you to actually buy, you make your buy, stop loss below the zone, boom, take profit. You can aim to the 27 if you wish, or just go 1-2 risk to reward, because right now we're just creating new highs. There's nothing on the left where we can actually aim to take profit, right? So it could be a nice setup, okay, waiting for that little pullback right there, getting into the zone, finding your trigger, boom, buy, 1-2 risk to reward, or you aim to the 27. Alrighty, nice right there with NASDAQ. Let's go with US 30. US 30, as I was mentioning before, look the pullback, okay? Actually, US 30 is, in fact, doing the actual pullback. Look at that, okay? This is a daily time frame, right? See that previous record high is broken. So this would be like the second test. What do you guys think is going to happen here? Is it going to bounce? Probably. It's very possible. Is it going to continue down? It's very possible too, depending how news are. But at least if you open on the daily, your 50 SMA, you can see the market is actually getting closer right now to the 50 SMA, right? Like it did several times in the past, okay? So right now, not just because the market reached this zone, I'm going to buy. Be careful. Be careful because this could still be going down, right? Let's use the Fibonacci right there on the daily from that low to that high, okay? We are touching the golden zone already. We're touching the 38.20. So it's a nice zone to buy, yes. It's a good moment to enter right now? Not yet, okay? You have to wait for more confirmations right there, okay? So nice pullback right there. Okay, let's go 4 hours. Yeah, we were able to actually spot this nice flag here. I shared this setup actually on the VIP. So market is reaching that zone. We need to go, you know, find our entry. This is a lot of indecision right there. Crazy movements. A lot of noise, a lot of indecision. Market is, you know, that drop was huge, okay? Huge right there. A lot of sellers got in control right there. And it was a weird movement. If you can see, like yesterday, the market dropped as well and then started to push up. And then today, again, another drop. So basically, a lot of sellers here. But still, market wanted to push up, but no, sellers got in control. So anyways, this is it's a weird formation right there. It's just a consolidation, I would say. If you can spot something there. I don't know. It's just a consolidation. So it's very likely that somewhere around here we can spot a nice buy. So you could be aiming previous levels. This level or next level, right? Last high right there. Okay. So let's see. Still, like I mentioned, it's risky to just make an entry just because you need to wait for more confirmations. Most likely Monday will break and then come back down to retest again. Most likely we'll do a double bottom, triple bottom. Consolidate here before it actually starts pushing up, if it's actually going to push up. Okay, so right there, that's how US 30 is looking. At least it is completing already the pullback. You see the difference between US 30 and NASDAQ. The NASDAQ is just flying, and US 30 was actually doing the pullback. So do you think the NASDAQ will replicate, will actually repeat or duplicate or mirror the same as US 30? Let me know in the comment section below. Let's go on S&P 500. Also, take a look at that. Let's go on the daily. Let's go on the daily. Right here. Okay. So again, look at it in the past. Okay. So market pushes up, comes back down to retest the 50 SMA. Push it, retest, push, retest. Push it. So it's normally more on top of the 50 SMA than actually below, right? So right now you see how far we are. Same thing. We are very far away from the 50 SMA. So a pullback is definitely expected. When? We don't know. We just go by what price action is telling us. Right now we see some type of consolidation or wedge, you know, to the upside. If you want to go in a sell, I think I spotted this in 1 hour. If you want to go on a sell, you wait for the breakout and you aim for previous zones. Okay, you aim for this previous 4 hour zone, you aim for this low, or you could be aiming for even for this zone as your last TP, right? But right there, this is a reversal, some type of reversal pattern. Okay, you find this at the end of a trend. Okay. Not necessarily means the market will drop. No, this could still continue pushing up, okay? So we just go by whatever direction is going to break. If it breaks to the upside, you buy. You know that the market will be creating most likely new record highs. So I suggest you going 1 to 2 risk to reward at least. And if it breaks to the downside, you go for a sell. All right? Don't get it complicated. That's what's happening on the market right now. You have those zones right there, 4 hour zones. Market is creating that wedge or a small consolidation right there in decisions. So I think it's about to fall. Let's see what's going to happen next week right there in that position. So I wanted to show also German 40 that also today, like, it's been creating record highs as well, ever right there. So also did a pullback as well. It did a correction, right? Today, so US 30, S&P 500, US 30 and German 40 actually did the pullback. It did the pullback today, but S&P 500 and NASDAQ, they were still kind of bullish, still bullish. So you see on the 4 hour, the market right now, this is a really nice trend right there. Really nice trend right there for German 40. So it's touching your trend, is touching the 50 SMA. So again, if you want to go on a sell right here, you wait for the breakout and aim for lower zones, previous zones. Okay, it could reach perhaps previous highs right there next week with that. But that is basically it. Let's take a look right quick at gold as well. I think we had this setup. We were waiting for this. Let me remove this. Okay, market, let's go from the daily. Okay, you see that breakout we were predicting for a very long time from the market was somewhere around here, was predicting that breakout. Now, of course, you see that big push, most likely is going to do a pullback. Okay, use your Fibonacci again from the low to that high. So price, I'm sure it's going to reach this previous zone. Okay, this is a very strong in the past. There's nothing else, a lot of noise right here, but yeah, it's very likely the market will reach this zone, and here we can try to spot some type of buys, okay? But knowing gold, be careful, it's very crazy, and, you know, very, very crazy. So right now you can see on the daily, let me go with price action right here. Price was coming down, boom, boom, and then the moment it starts, create the first higher low. Right there, it breaks, creates the first higher high, okay? Then pullback, still is a higher low, push, create a high high, new high high. So goes back down, still is a higher low. Now breaks very strong to the upside, which is an entire momentum. A lot of rich people right here were actually buying, you know, entities, banks, all of that, getting into gold. And now we need a pullback. Is expected. Look, this pullback right here, the gold could actually go as low as this if they want, okay? If gold wants, it can go as low as this, and it still would be creating a higher low, right? So it's very possible. It's very possible the market could even come back down here to retest the channel, and then perhaps continuation to the upside, right? Gold is very crazy when it comes to that, so yeah. Keep an eye on that. You see all that noise, that consolidation. So yeah, most likely we're going to have gold continuing dropping at least to the zone, at least to that zone. And then perhaps we can have, we can make decisions at that zone. Alrighty. So that would be basically it for today's analysis, guys. This is the expectations for next week. Let me know in your in the comment section below, you know, if you have any doubts, questions, something you want to see me post next. I'll see if I do a poll actually on my Telegram group. Follow me on Telegram as well if you want to see these analyses being posted there every day. Also, go ahead and check my website, teamprofitsfx.com, if you're interested in getting the actual mentorship or course. There is a sale now from November 15 until December 15, guys, if you want to get the actual course plus the mentorship. Right there is just only $80. All right, get it soon since it's limited. So again, guys, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Take it easy, guys. A nigga want it, he can get it. Trouble man, a motherfucking fool with it. Okay, bullet automatic, better have you one of them. Play with them other niggas, shout out, I ain't no